So good day everyone, my name is John Dave Plaza Colintes and I am here today because I am going to report the Rizal, Morga and the Ilustrado's views of the pre-conquest. So before that, before I am going to tackle that one, so let us discover first who is Morga. Antonio D. Morga Sanchez Garay was a Spanish soldier, lawyer and a high-ranking colonial officer for 43 years in the Philippines, New Spain, and Peru, where he was president of the Real Audiencia for 20 years. He was also a historian. He wrote the Sucesos de las Islas Filipinas. So si Morga daw is a great leader. He is also a historian. So let us discover what is he wrote. The Sucesos de las Islas Filipinas. So, Sucesos means it is an event, happenings, or an occurrence, and the work of the honest observer, a versatile and bureaucrat who knew the workings of the administrations from the inside. So, meaning to say, ang Sucesos daw event or pangyayari or mga panghitabo. De las Islas Filipinas means the islands of the Philippines. The Philippines was named in the honor of the King Philip II of Spain. So, De las Islas Filipinas daw, the island of the Philippines or ang atong island sa Filipinas. What is Sucesos De las Islas Filipinas? Ano nga ba ang Sucesos De las Islas Filipinas? So, Sucesos De las Islas Filipinas is an English event in the Philippines island, is a book written and published by Antonio D. Morga, considered as one of the most important works on the early history of the Spanish colonizations of the Philippines. It was published in 1609 after he was resigned to Mexico, in two volumes by Casa de Jeronimo Belli in Mexico City. The first English translations was published in London in 1868, and another English translations by Blair and Robertson was published in Cleveland in the Philippines in 1907. So, ang Sucesos De las Islas Filipinas is one of the important history in the Philippines because diri nakasulat ang history sa mga Philippines or mga panghitabo or mga pangyayari sa Pilipinas. So, Sucesos De las Islas Filipinas. So, one of the first book ever to tackle of the Philippine history. So, ayun na nga, natackle na sabi na nga kanina, matackle daw ang Philippine history. We're talking about the Philippine history. Book that describe events inside and outside of the country from 1493 to 1603, including the history of the Philippines, consists of 8 chapters. Discuss the political, social, and economic aspects of colonizers and colonized country. So, ma-discuss daw diri ang mga economic aspects, mga social, colonizers, mga kinsa yung mga colonizer. So, based on the documentary research, observations, and personal experience of Morga. So, base rani sa mga experience o mga nagihan ni Morga. Rizal is a secondary source of the book due to annotation. So, si Rizal daw is a secondary lang, or meaning to say, pangkaduha lang siya, or dili siya ang original nga nag-wrote aning Sucesos De las Islas Filipinas. Iyarang gi-annotate. Meaning to say, annotations, or iyan na siya gi-bago, or na siya gi-tarong, or na siya gi- meaning to say na siya gibag-o sa book or na siya gituwid kung straight kung hiwi pa ayan na pa siya na si Rizal gi straight or na siya gi correct or correction kana correction.
And now
We are done tackling about Successos de las Islas Filipinas. And now, let us know why Rizal annotate the book. Or, nga nung gi-annotate ni Rizal ang book about History of the Philippines wrote by Morga. So, let us proceed to our next slide. So, the discovery of Morga's Successos de las Islas Filipinas proved to be serendipitous to Rizal. He had been rethinking the idea of the Filipino not as one who were equal to their Spanish colonizers, but a people with a unique civilization that was destroyed by colonization. Rizal found the answer to his idea in Morga's book, and it was this work that he decided to reprint with his annotation. So, serendipitous meaning to say a good luck. So, this one is maroni ang nagpag-good luck kang Rizal to lead his annotation. Jose Rizal rewrote the Philippine history of his time with what has now been considered as his second major work. The Morga annotations provide the seeds of idea of how the Filipinos should view themselves amidst a growing nationalism that eventually led to formations of the nation. So, si Rizal daw is gi-rewrote daw niya or gi-sulat niya kutro. By publishing his annotated version of the Morga Success de las Islas Filipinas or the Events of the Philippines Islands originally published in 1609, his annotations include clarification and amplification of the details, refutations of statements where necessary, and confirmations when checked against other sources. So, ang gibuhat daw ni Rizal diri is gi-annote niya, gibutang niya is mga clarifications, amplifications of details, and refutations statement. So, this time, let us witness the criticism of Dr. Jose Rizal of the book Successos de las Islas Filipinas wrote by Morga. Some criticisms of Rizal on Morga's views. Number 1. So the fish that Morga mentions that cannot be good until it begins to rot is bagoong, or the salted and fermented fish or shrimp paste used as a sauce in Filipino cuisine. And those who have eaten in the taste is know that neither is nor should be rotten. So one of the mention of Morga is the bagoong, which is the exotic food of the Philippines. Ana si Morga, once daw nga marate na ang isa ka foodies, dili na siya pwede good or pwede kaunon. Number 2, Christianity was a weapon to facilitating the political and economic subjection of native. So, ang iyon ni Rizal is, walay labot ang Christianity sa political. So, number 3, Rizal noticed all Morga's mistake. Morga misspelled many native names, places, flora and fauna, and other social classes, which is Rizal's corrected. So, nangatang mga places, instances diri sa Philippines nga namali ni Morga og mga spelling, mga places nga, mga native places nga spell out ni Morga is mga mali-mali. Rizal emphasized that native women, unlike their European counterparts, never lost their nobles titles. It was groom who have dowry to the parents because they're going to lose their precious daughter. So, Rizal collaborate the differences between Europeans and our natives. So, number 5. Rizal clarified Morga must have meant sinamay, which was woven from abaca thread that comes from the banana trunks, not from the leaves. So this time, Morga is wrong and Rizal is factual. This time, let us know about the intentions of Rizal that he annotate the book of Morga. Rizal's intention for his views. First, to provide the Filipino people of their early history a pre-Spanish history. So Rizal provide a factual history for our Filipino people. Number 2, to present the people of their own authentic culture and identity. So this establish to our beliefs, culture, and our paniniwala in our own way. So, third and the last, to invoke the testimony of an ilustros Spaniard who governed distance of the Philippines in the beginning of her new era and witnessed the last moments of our ancient nationality. We have here the three propositions of Rizal. So number one, the people of the Philippines have the culture of their own before the coming of the Spaniards. So before pa ni arrive ang mga Spaniards in the Philippines, nanatay kaugalingon nga paniniwala, nanatay kaugaling nga culture, nanatay kaugalingon our own way of our culture in the Philippines. Number two, Filipinos were disseminated, demoralized, exploited, and ruined by the Spanish colonized. So, dire is gi comparison sa mga Spaniards because before ni abot ang mga Spaniards diri sa Philippines is peaceful pa ang Pilipinas. Pag abot na sa mga Spaniards is nagagubot na, like nag-create nag mga war like that. So number three, the present states of the Philippines was necessarily superior to it was. So ang gusto lang ni Rizal Dria is ma-figure out sa mga Filipino kung unsay panghitabo sa una ug karon. So sa una, therefore was nga wala pa ang mga Spaniards they came in the Philippines, wala pa'y gubot, peaceful pa, wala pa'y patay nga nahitabo, wala pa'y mga kagubot. And back then, pag-abot sa mga Spaniards is nag-create lang sila og mga many wars, many conflicts in our country, like some other nga nakasulat sa root sa mga history nga ginasulat ni Rizal sa iyang mga written book. So here is the importance of Rizal annotations of the present generations. So number one, to awaken the consciousness of us as a Filipino in our past. Number two, to devote ourselves in studying the future. Number three, to first lay bare the past in order to the better judge and present and to survey the road trodden during the three countries. Number four, to prove the Filipinos had a culture on their own prior to colonize, that the Filipinos were not inferior to the white man. Number five, to shatter the myth of the so-called indolence of the Filipinos. Number six, to reduce those Filipinos who denied their native tongue into the frozen fish. Number seven, to seriously study Tagalog and produce a comprehensive Tagalog dictionary. Number eight, to embrace the generic term Indio, or in today's case, Filipino, with all the negative connotations and turn into one of dignity and nobility. So, Dr. Rizal wants us to awaken our knowledge about the Spaniards. About this novel, about this topic is gusto lang ipaabot ni Rizal sa ato nga kanang mabuhi ta bisag walay Spaniards. Kanang sa una, therefore, ang mga Pilipino is independent pa or wala pa sila nagsalig sa ubang bansa. Kanang we have our own culture, we have our own beliefs, paniniwala in different places . So, thank you for watching. I hope nga nadugangan inyong knowledge. I hope nga naamoy na katunan sa lesson nga akong gitakel about this day. So, thank you for watching. God bless and mabuhay.